We will now like to start the explanation regarding Hitachi Smart Transformation Project. Mr. Shinjiro Iwata, CTRO, will provide the explanation. My name is Iwata. I would like to explain to you the Hitachi Smart Transformation Project, but I would like to refer to this as STP from now onward. Now, this is the outline of my presentation. On the part of the Hitachi Group, as we have explained on previous occasions, in order to drive the growth in terms of social innovation business, we have been emphasizing innovation and global. The mission of STP is to change the Hitachi Group to an organization that can generate the cash to enable investment for growth. In the past, in terms of profit, cash generation, strengthening measures have been implemented in terms of cost structure reform as well as CCC reform as well. Also, we have been improving the business base as well. These are the three pillars in our work. Now, in terms of the business base, this may not be familiar to you, but in terms of strengthening the social innovation business, it is important to fundamentally review the business base of the Hitachi Group. Last month, when Higashihara's president explained this point, a market-oriented organization is required. By so doing, the internal processes as well as accountability for profit will be subject to change. In order to realize this, it is important to have a business base which is simple, transparent, as well as productive. This is one of our responsibilities to achieve this objective. Next, I'd like to talk about the vision for STP. We would like to generate a double-digit profit. In the process of achieving this goal, in 2015, there will be a milestone point to be achieved. A profit margin of 6.7% should be pursued. And we should also bear in mind the objective of achieving 7% as well. Cost structure reform must be implemented. 100 billion will be increased by another 10 billion. And as a result, on a cumulative basis, we would like to achieve 420 billion. And for CCC, a cash conversion cycle, the target is 76.5 days. Next, I'd like to talk about the progress for fiscal year 14. Please refer to this. This is the cost at the moment. Last year, we have achieved 100 billion, although the target was 90 billion, increase of 10 billion over our target for 2015. Against the plan of 100 billion, we would like to achieve 110 billion. This is the internal target. This is the cost overall. Cost of sales reduction has been continuing. This is according to schedule. We are making progress in this regard. In terms of SG&A, however, there is much more to be done. As mentioned here, cost of sales reduction will be continued by various measures, and the results have been shown. But in terms of SG&A, the fixed cost domestically will have to be subject to review, and indirect material cost overseas will have to be improved. Now, this is the factors for change from 2013 to 2014. Please refer to the red area, the arrows toward the left. This is the lower sales price, and the blue looking up is the cost reduction effect. And the net benefit is plus 100 billion. This is the benefit of HTP. On the other hand, let's look at the CCC. The actual for 2014 compared to 2013 is flat. Therefore, further measures are required. There is much more to be done. In terms of inventory turnover, will have to be improved. In many business bases, we have made improvements in terms of accounts receivable and payment payable turnover. We are pursuing this in certain divisions, but it is not across the board. Therefore, in this area, CCC responsible officer will be designated for each in-house company so that the various measures can be implemented to achieve this goal. And next, I would like to talk about the targets for 2015. Now, as I have mentioned, for 2015, there are three pillars. First is cost structure reform. And as you can see on the right-hand side, there will be changes in the environment, and we need to be agile in responding to the changes in the environment. Project management must be strengthened because this has been an issue over the years. We would like to reduce losses. In terms of reduction of SG&A expenses, we must optimize the global workforce. For CCC reform, reducing inventories will be required. We have to be able to adapt to supply and demand dynamics. Process will be improved. In terms of improving accounts receivable and payable turnover, we will strengthen the cash flow management close to the front line. Improvements will be made. Next is the establishment of the business base. I would like to further elaborate on this point later. Through these activities from 2014 to 2015, as you can see in the waterfall chart here, from 600 billion to 640 billion efforts will be underway. Now, in terms of lower sales price is 100 billion, and right-hand side, the cost reduction is 200 billion. The benefit of HTP will be, as STP will be 100 billion. Plus alpha, 10 billion effort will be made on top of this. Now, against this backdrop, in terms of cost, depending on the business environment, there are various measures that can be implemented. This is extremely important. Therefore, when there is a change in the business environment or if there is a contingency, we have to make sure that we can achieve the target without fail. We are discussing how to enable this. Now, please look at the right-hand side from the bottom. First of all, it is important to have an expansion of the management dashboard. And on top of that, we have to understand the revenue changes and make early a decision. And scenarios will have to be considered. And this must be done on a continuous basis. This is the loss cost reduction in project management. In terms of project management, there are two areas that we have to consider. First is the establishment of information, and the other is power system and infrastructure, where there is a significant construction, EPC projects. And here, I would like to talk about the EPC projects with significant construction involved. In the past, there have been successes and failures. And these track record must be accumulated to generate know-how to be shared. Now, as you can see on the right-hand top, we are training the project management human resources. There are 19 courses available. And on the left-hand side, We will establish a common platform for project management. And best practices, as well as failures, will be made available across the organization. At the left hand bottom, we will establish a project management support team. This team is comprised of specialists, and they will be dispatched to provide support in project management. This is the cost side. What we must do is to share the back office operations. The sharing of back office operations as well as BPO have been promoted over the years. In overseas, as you can see on the left hand top, we started with finance. And the blue area have been completed by 2014. So more than half have made progress. And in terms of human assets, you can see that the progress is made, as well as the procurement area has made progress. Now, domestically, the sharing of finance services have made progress. We will convert this to BPO. This has been announced. So this will be identified for BPO. In the area of human capital, it will be sharing of back office first. We have centralized the work for 177 companies and 190,000 people to be shared. Now, this is very similar to what I have referred to earlier. It is to enhance our ability to meet the changing environment. End-to-end measures must be connected so that lead time can be reduced. Modular design, as well as a global distributed design, will be pursued. These are the what we have achieved so far. On the left-hand side, we have the global logistics scheme. And going forward, we will build the global PSI operations as well. PSI stands for production, sales, and inventory. We would like to visualize PSI immediately. In terms of the sales activities, I'd like to talk about the pipeline activities later. By connecting measures from end to end, we would like to set up an organization that will be agile to meet the changing environment. Next is cash flow management. Within Hitachi Group, we have different types of business models. As you mentioned here, one is the project type, the other is as mass production parts, or mid-size, medium volume production is also the business model that we have. And depending on the type of business, the cycle of business as well as the relationship with customers may differ. And that will mean that the cash flow management will differ from business to business. According to the characteristics of the business, we are making improvements in CCC. For example, for project type, for infrastructure, as you can see on the right-hand side, the starting point is very important in establishing transaction with the customers, as well as placing the bid and concluding contract is very important in terms of cash management. It will have a significant impact going forward in the future. And specifications could change as well. We must make steadfast efforts here. Especially in the overseas market, the contract is extremely important. So we must make improvements in this regard. This is the business base. There are two points to be covered here. Last month, President Higashihara gave a presentation on this point. The group structure will be converted to a market-oriented organization. In the past, the plant and business divisions will optimize the product and services, but it was individual optimization. This has continued for nearly 100 years in terms of social innovation, as well as providing solutions to customers when these objectives must be met. The conventional functions did not suffice. That is the reason why we have to implement this change. Front office-driven approach will be required, whether it be sales, engineering, as well as consulting. As you can see on the right-hand side, in terms of the work processes as well as procedural rules must be standardized. We need to make significant changes in this area. IT must support this as well. This will also require changes to be implemented. Next is the management of the pipeline. Sales and business divisions in the past were separate. The sales will receive orders, and there was separate budget for the plant, but these must be connected. In terms of sales, if a project is 10 billion, 5 billion will be considered in the budget. But this will not lead to actual sales. But we are going to change. We will include everything in the pipeline, and we will estimate what kind of sales can be achieved. 3 months, 6 months, 1 year down the road, the plant side will know the production level that will be required. And preemptive procurement can take place, which will be less cost. So we need to manage this on a seamless basis. You may believe that it is done in other companies, but we have not been able to achieve this in the past. We will make further efforts to achieve this project pipeline management. In terms of the midterm management plan for 2015, cost structure reform will be implemented without fail. Various measures are implemented. As you can see here, we must make steadfast efforts to achieve the numbers. In terms of the CCC reforms, on the other hand, we made focused efforts from last year. Therefore, there is much more to be done. We will continue to achieve 76.5 days. And in terms of business base, we will consider this in 2015, and actual measures will be implemented, executed from 2016 onward. Let me conclude. Now, as I have mentioned already, in terms of STP, we would like to reap project benefit of 100 billion. And CCC date will be 76.5 days, so that we can contribute to the Hitachi Group. Last year, Mr. Ishizuka, who was my predecessor, showed the poster that is shown here at the left-hand top. Now, I believe there was a question raised regarding the awareness within the group. And now, further efforts are made, as you can see on the left-hand bottom. And individual optimization must be changed to achieve group overall optimization. The whole power of Hitachi Group must be brought to bear, because we can do much more compared to individual efforts. That is what we would like to achieve. Thank you very much for your kind attention. I will now like to open the floor for questions. And Mr. Nakayama, of Head of Monozukuri and Quality Assurance, as well as Mr. Masashi Murayama of the Smart Transformation Project Initiative Division, will also join the QA period. Question. Thank you very much for the kind explanation. I have two questions. First question is regarding STP. The waterfall chart is shown here, and price decline and cost reduction has been achieved. This is the benefit of STB. I understand the results for last year, but what is your view for this year? Considering the current environment, it is a plan, but forex assumption is 115 and the euro is 124 yen. This is the forex assumption for your company. And the crude oil will have a significant impact as well. So I believe that the 200 billion cost reduction it does not seem enough. In fact, 10 billion is not enough. So because I think it on a natural course, you can achieve 20 billion or 30 billion. So because of a price decline, inclusive of price decline. I think 10 billion is too conservative. Taking into the current environment, several tens of billions can be achieved. So please talk about the plan and your current view on this topic. Second question is regarding the business base. EPC, the successes and failures have been mentioned. If it's an advanced nation, if you have a good contract, you can have various provisions. But Thailand is also an area where you can win a contract for a railway. But the contract may not be valid. And for Brazil, similar situation is there. So. Project. What is your view in terms of project management, inclusive of political areas, in order to capture large deals? There are risks, especially for emerging markets. So bold and significant risk management is required. So please talk about your views on this topic. Answer. In terms of STP, foreign exchange, oil, is as you have mentioned, these are major factors. But in terms of material cost, from outside, we are importing significant volumes. The numbers cannot be given in detail, but there is a cost increase factors as well. This has continued from last year. With crude oil, the raw material cost is declining. This is a positive impact. This will also be fully incorporated. So it isn't as if either side is going to be significantly positive or negative. That is not the case for 2015. And we have a tendency to be conservative. And that is the reason why we have this forecast. However, I do understand the various criticisms that we are receiving. We are a company of 10 trillion, and 200 billion is something that we cannot be boastful about, is a criticism. I believe that a fundamental review will be required. But for up until 2015, we would like to continue on the current course. Various measures are implemented. And in terms of operations, we will make progress in terms of improvements. Based on that, front office-driven type organization will be established, and then we will consider bold measures. Big data is a good case in point. We need to provide support horizontally to various industries. That will mean that the methods applicable may change. We need to fundamentally review this. As for EPC, on the other hand, first and foremost, we need to be competitive in areas where contracts are valid. Because if you work in Japan, the contract provides that problems will be resolved in good faith by both parties. But that is not valid overseas. EPC means that we have to hire people locally as well. Region by region, the characteristics may differ, and the way we hire people, customs may differ. So we have to consider where we are going to start. We have to also consider which industry we want to tackle first before going on to the next step. We are not mature yet in this area. for Latin American countries. And I don't want to cite any countries, but where there is a difference in terms of culture and views, we have to be very careful. A question regarding STP cost is increasing, material cost is increasing, as you have mentioned. But there is excess in terms of steel, and copper prices are declining. Is it because the intermediate materials on a dollar-denominated basis is increasing? Is that what you're saying? Is there measures that you can implement to overcome this area? Answer. Now, regarding commodity product in terms of copper as well as crude oil, from the beginning of this year, the price declined significantly. For this area, we had already implemented measures, and we will reap the benefit during this fiscal year. On the other hand, for steel products, the iron ore, which is the raw material, as well as coal, compared to previous years, it has declined significantly. That is true. However, it isn't as if we can purchase on a cost-plus basis. Supply and demand will have an impact. We also have the relationship with the steel manufacturers that must be coordinated well. And that will determine the price. Currently, we are trying to negotiate as much as possible. And ultimately, we believe that benefit can be reaped. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Question.
I have two questions. Regarding the human resource allocation, as you mentioned, in SG&A, you said you need to reallocate the personnel in Japan. But on the other hand, on the front line, you said you need to place more people. I understand that well. But maybe the type of human resource you need is different. You often talk about frontline and BOT, President Higashihara talked about Rio Tinto, but it's not that someone can suddenly go to Rio Tinto. So when you think of your global business, you may have surplus human resource in Japan, but on the other hand, in frontline, one-stop shopping, I think, will be emerging. So in the emerging markets that you have not done much, some hiring or development of human resource who can do the emerging markets, maybe the total headcount may not change, but maybe the breakdown or the content has to change. So you may not be able to talk about this in detail, but what your basic idea is, reallocation or increase, then decrease, and then increase somewhere else. What is your basic understanding? Second question. You may not be directly in charge, but the use of cash. Social infrastructure will increase. And a nuclear power, I think, is a typical example. It will not be a simple investment, but the business investment, including equity subscription, may be a possibility. So the cash efficiency point of view, if that is included in the smart transformation project, then apart from the cash conversion cycle, the investment control, in case of nuclear power, the return, investment return becomes longer, so you may reduce 100 billion yen, but on the other hand, invest as much in the nuclear power, 200 billion in nuclear power. So, answer regarding the HR. As the person in charge of Japanese companies, we need to educate, develop the people we have so that they can play important roles in new areas. That is our priority. However, what kind of yield can we realize that with? There are many challenges, but this is something we have to do. In case of Rio Tinto, things start moving when in Australia the experts in industries or areas are hired. So that's when things start moving, when we hire experts. Market-oriented means customer-oriented, so the people who understand customers' business have to be at the front line. When we expand products, similar example, another example, in HDS, when we do healthcare, ordinary person cannot do this. They have to understand the challenges in the hospitals and healthcare, especially the experts in hospitals has to be experts. And when we have them, then things start moving. So when we do things in the outside market, we have to hire external people. So dialogue with customers. We have interaction with customers. How far can we go? It is not clear. But we've tried this many times in the past. We will make as much effort as we can. Now, second is not my direct domain, but horizon. If your question is about a horizon, then the necessary amount? Oh, no, Lithuania. Okay. Lithuania, be it horizon. The magnitude is different. And so our current business, managed with the cash from some cash cow, it's different from that because the magnitude is different. So we need investment partners and partners in other areas too. In the UK project, can Japanese just go and do the business? No. We need to understand local rules and the rules of the price setting. So it's similar to the example I talked about earlier. We need local people who understand local business, local customers, and the business customs, way of doing business. Similar for transportation. We are going ahead with an M&A this time, so we need to utilize experts. It's a very important factor. However, the formal response will be made from CFO or CEO, so please ask them.
We would like to take the last question before we close this session. Question. I have one question. Now, slide 23, you talked about the SG&A. For the new year, it is going to decline. But according to the graph, it seems that it is going to increase. Regarding the SG&A expense, the ratio is going to increase. I would like to ask the reason why this is the case. And a related question is the following. With respect to SDP scope, the group corporate reorganization is what I would like to receive an update on. In terms of SG&A ratio to be reduced, as an effective measure, you have both the parent subsidiary listing, which is quite significant in the group. I believe that this can be subject to review as well. So I would like to know why this is tolerated currently, and what are the discussions taking place at the board as well as management committee that has led to the conclusion of this plan today. Regarding SG&A, page 23, why has this increased? Answer. For the individual companies, whether the information as well as for metals, acquisition has been made, and when revenues are increased, there will be an increase in certain areas. But the issue is that we have not seen reduction elsewhere. So that means that further review will be required. Toward the next fiscal year, it says 21.2, and we must reduce this by from this level. We are discussing this, and measures are being discussed. We would like to make progress in this area going forward. By the middle of this year, I believe that further information can be shared with you. Now, regarding group reorganization, there are listed companies as well as non-listed group companies. For the non-listed group companies, we have been reorganizing. We have made progress in this regard. Compared to 5 or 6 years ago, not 10 years ago, but 5 or 6 years ago, overall, the affiliated companies were more than 900. We had more than 900. And two-thirds, or 600 or 700, were domestic companies. And we have gone through a process of consolidation. And overseas is now two-thirds, and one-third is Japanese companies, companies in Japan. So that is the case for non-listed companies. We have been trying to consolidate, reorganize over the years. And for major companies, sharing of operations will be pursued. For example, each of the companies may have education as well as a PR. These functions can be consolidated. These is steadfast efforts that are underway. Now, in terms of the management divisions by plant, will be changed to region-based. This is something that has gone on for 100 years. We must review this going forward. As for listed companies, it would not be appropriate for me to comment here. Obviously, the board members have stated their views, and we have to also take into consideration efficiency of cash, and I believe that the further consideration will be required going forward. With this, we would like to bring the STP explanation to a close. Thank you very much.